Hello everyone, I am Dr. Guraj Chitchil, working as an associate professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Vidya Vardhaka College of Engineering, Mysuru. As a part of VTU eShikshana program, I'm dealing with application layer. As I covered almost all the topic of year syllabus of application layer, in the rest of the sessions, I'm going to deal with the few question papers of year OA. Examination question paper solving session. Okay, we'll solve 4 to 5 question papers. In this session, I'm going to deal with the first question paper with the first module, and you have to write the systematic answer with neat diagrams and comparisons and the problems wherever required. You have to solve appropriately. Okay, so in the session, I'm going to deal with one of the question paper of computer networks. This is the question paper of 2017-18 of December, January, and which is a scheme of 15 CS52, which retains the same content of year syllabus first module. Okay, so in this session, we are going to deal with the different aspect of writing the answers for different questions which are already appeared in the previous question paper. Okay, and I'm going to share with the presentation, and also I'm going to share with the solutions of what I had written for the answers for your kind perusal, for your better understanding. Okay, so without wasting the time, we'll deal with the first question of your syllabus, that is module number one. The question is, compare client server and peer-to-peer architecture. Okay, as the question says about comparison between the two important architecture, if you remember the first module of the first topic what I had covered in your first module, itself is the two important network architectures. Which are those architectures? One is client server architecture and one is peer to peer architecture. Okay, so at the outset, if you would have heard of this name, client and server architecture, immediately there will be a single point of connection. Imagination comes to our mind. Okay, and we have went with various examples and also various the advantages and also the disadvantages of client server architecture in your first module. Okay, and along with that, there is one more contrast architecture we have called as peer-to-peer architecture. Peer-to-peer architecture is also one of the important network architecture, and which is going to have different architecture compared to client server, and there is no single point of connection. And in your first module, we also saw the different advantages, different versions of peer-to-peer architecture, and also the advantages which with respect to security concern especially, and also the loopholes of peer-to-peer architecture in your previous session. Okay, well, let me go within the second important question is, describe HTTP with persistent and non-persistent connection. Okay, and the third question is, what are the services provided by DNS? Okay, so we'll see one by one. As I explained the question number one, compare client server and peer-to-peer architecture, and I had asked this for 5 marks. So you have to write at least 5 differences between client server and peer-to-peer architecture. Okay, so let me see the solution for this. As the first question says about the differences between client server and peer to peer architecture, you have, if it is for 5 marks, no need to write any kind of architectures or diagrams. If it is more than 5 marks, please try to write this architecture before explaining the differences or comparison between client server model and peer to peer model. Okay, what is the meaning of client server model, network model? We have a single server, as you see here, and we have various number of clients. All these clients can able to send the request via internet to the server, and the server job is to respond back to all these clients if the request, if it is present in the server. Similarly, there is one more important architecture. We don't have any kind of server part here, and all nodes will act individually by its own, and each and every node will behave like a server and also like a client. We don't have any single server architecture in case of peer-to-peer. The nodes are distributed here. Okay, so each and every node, if they want to communicate, they can also communicate with any other node. Okay, this model is called as peer-to-peer network model. Let us see the differences between these two important models. The first important differences between the client-server architecture and peer-to-peer architecture is, in client-server architecture, clients and servers are differentiated, specific servers and clients are present. Okay. But in case of peer-to-peer architecture, the clients and servers are not differentiated. Okay, so the second important difference between client-server and peer-to-peer architecture is, client-server network focuses on information sharing, where in case peer-to-peer focuses on connectivity between the nodes or connectivity between the peers. The third important difference between the client-server and peer-to-peer architecture is, in client-server network, centralized server is used to store the data, while in peer-to-peer network, each peer has its own data. Okay. Hence, this client-server architecture is also called as centralized architecture, and peer-to-peer architecture is also called as decentralized architecture. In client-server network, server responds to services which is requested by the respective clients. But in case of peer-to-peer network, each and every node can be both be request and respond for the services. We don't have any difference of client and server in case of peer-to-peer architecture. Each and every node in the network can able to send the request and also can able to receive the response. In case of client-server network, the client-server network are costlier than peer-to-peer network. They are costlier than peer-to-peer network, while peer-to-peer network are costlier than client-server network. Okay, so this also somewhat, if you want to invest a client, it will take huge amount of investment to construct or configure the server data centers, and if something fails to fail its operation, the complete network fails its operation. Okay, so that is one more important difference between client server architecture and peer-to-peer architecture. Okay, so if the question is only for 5 marks, please kindly write the answer of these 5 differences. If it is more than that, kindly enhance your answer with those 2 model diagrams what I had already explained, along with more differences. The next important difference what we have is, client server network are more stable than peer-to-peer network, while peer-to-peer network are less stable if the number of peers is increased. If the number of nodes or peers increase in peer-to-peer network, somewhat the peer-to-peer network are not stable. Okay. Client-server network is used both for small and also for large network, while peer-to-peer network is generally suited for small network with less than 10 computers. If it is more computers, it's very complicated, and peer-to-peer network usually does not sustain its operation. The operation become complex, and the efficiency will be also not high. Okay, these are the major differences between client-server and peer-to-peer architecture. With the help of these two models, you have to explain. Apart from these, there are some more issues and examples you can highlight. Few examples for client-server are Amazon, Flipkart, Big Billion, Google, whatever you can explain with an examples. But peer-to-peer, we have BitTorrent application and other application you can mention. And one more major drawback of peer-to-peer model is security. Okay, in case of client server, if you provide security for the server, it's enough. But in case of peer-to-peer, you cannot trust on anybody, and we cannot able to have a much security compared to client server model. Okay, so this is the summary or the explanation what we can have for the first question, what we saw in your question paper. That is, compare client server and peer-to-peer architecture. Okay, so with a better understanding of the first question, we can go to the second question of this question paper. What is that? Describe HTTP with persistent and non-persistent connection. Okay, basically HTTP is one of the application layer protocol. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which is one of the finest protocol we have in application layer. In your for model number one, in the lecture series, you can able to see the detailed conceptual brief of HTTP protocol with its header format, request message format and response message format, and various operation of HTTP in that lecture, in the previous lectures. Okay, as the question says about, describe HTTP with persistent and non-persistent connection. HTTP can have two types of connection. One is persistent connection and one more is non-persistent connections. We'll see, and they had asked this question for 8 marks. So we should be very careful enough while writing the answer about 8 marks on persistent and non-persistent connection. Okay, we'll go to the solution now. Okay, basically, before writing the detailed concept of HTTP types of connection, you have to highlight two important statements about HTTP protocol. HTTP protocol is the hypertext transfer protocol, which is one of the application level protocol that uses the down layer protocol as TCP. If you remember, TCP is nothing but transmission control protocol of transport layer. And HTTP protocol mainly runs on port number 80. Okay, HTTP is a stateless protocol. That is, server maintains no information about past client requests. Okay, hence HTTP is also called as stateless protocol. Okay, HTTP connection, which is going to build with the help of TCP protocol of underlying protocol under transport layer, we have two important type of connection. One is non-persistent connection and one is persistent connection. Okay, before starting with persistent and non-persistent HTTP connection, let us know what is RTT. Many of you people, I think, remember regarding RTT, which I had explained in the first module while explaining HTTP protocol. RTT is nothing but round trip time. Okay, the time for a small packet to travel from client to server and back. Okay, the total time required for persistent connection is equal to 2 into propagation time. total time required for any protocol to, any client to send a request and response back is equal to 2 into propagation time. What is the meaning of propagation time? The time required to send a request or the time required to get the response. It's called as propagation time. Okay. Let us see how the persistent and non-persistent connection works. For a connection of persistent or non-persistent, it is sure that to initiate TCP connection or TCP connection, one RTT is used. For any TCP connection, one RTT will be always used. One RTT is used for HTTP request and first few bytes to HTTP response to return. So, in order to know total final transmission time, the total time incurred is equal to 2 RTT plus transmit time. Okay, and I have given more details on HTTP persistent and non-persistent connection in your regular lecture. What are the major impact of HTTP persistent and non-persistent connection? We can see here. Always non-persistent HTTP connection requires 2 RTTs for per object, which means that each and every request sent by the client to the receiver, and you have to get back the response for each and every object. But in case of persistent connection, we don't require for each and every object the response. We can get the response for all the objects in one iteration. That is a major difference between non-persistent and persistent connection. Obviously, in case of persistent, we require less HTTP, RTT required. In case of non-persistent, we require higher RTT. So, OS overhead for each TCP connection we have in non-persistent, subsequent HTTP messages between same client and server sent over upon same connection. Okay, and at last, browsers often open parallel TCP connection to fetch the reference object. Okay, but in case of persistent connection, client sends a request as soon as it encounters a referenced object. As little as RTT for all the reference objects. This is the major difference between non-persistent and persistent connection. Okay, as I had mentioned for 8 marks, you have to explain the detailing of RTT and initially you have to give the highlight of what is HTTP protocol, detailing of RTT, and then you have to give the two flavors of HTTP connection. Connection can be have persistent connection and also have non-persistent connection. With the detailing of persistent and non-persistent meaning, you have to explain this important information for 8 marks. Okay. I hope you got the logic of non-persistent and persistent connection, and for more details, you can visit my previous lecture on persistent and non-persistent HTTP connection. Now, we'll go to the last question of your first module, which is, I hope you got cleared with the first two questions, which are those, compare client-server and peer-to-peer architecture and describe HTTP with persistent and non-persistent connection. We'll go with the last question of the first module, or whichever, what is that? What are the services provided by DNS? Okay, let us see what is DNS and how DNS works. I think DNS is nothing but domain name system or domain name server, which is also present in application layer. We discuss about application layer domain name server in a regular lecture. Kindly see that lecture for more details. As I had mentioned the different types of services provided by domain name system, we can able to answer this. Okay, every host identified by the IP address, but remembering the numbers is not at all so easy. IP address has to be represented with the help of numbers. Okay, so remembering such numbers is not so easy. So people and also the IP address are not static. Therefore, a mapping of required IP address to the domain names is very important. Okay, so this operation is called as domain name system. It has to be done by domain name server. DNS is used to convert the domain names of the website to their numerical IP addresses. That is the job of domain name system. Basically, this also happens in application layer. Okay, and basically there are various kinds of domains. One is generic domain, country domain, and inverse domain. Generic domain is one that will be used commonly across globe. For example, .com for commercial purposes, for .edu for education purposes, .mil for military purposes, .org for non-profit organization. Similarly, .net, like similar or commercial. We have the second important category of domain, called as country domain. An example, .in stand for Indian, .us for USA, and .uk which stand for UK, United Kingdom. There is one more important type of domain called as inverse domain. If you want to know what is the domain name of the website, IP to domain name mapping is done with the help of DNS. So DNS can provide both the mapping, for example, to find the IP address of geeksforget.ac.in or whatever, then we have to type and just look up that domain name. Okay, so it might be vdu.ac.in or whatever the domain name. Immediately, its corresponding IP address will be displayed there. Okay, so the next important thing which you have to remember is organization of domain. How the domains are organized in a hierarchical fashion. It is very difficult to find out the IP address associated to a website because there are millions of websites with all those website, we should be able to generate the IP address immediately. There should not be a lot of delay for what to happen. Organization of database is very important. Hence, DNS record consists of, we have a domain name server. DNS record will be maintained by each and every website or web browser, which consists of mainly this information. Whether the domain name or IP address, what is the validity, what time to leave. Time to leave is a concept of the expiration date of that particular record. And all the information related to domain name, these records are stored in tree-like structure. You can see the tree-like structure architecture in the below diagram. Within which we have root DNS server, we can call it as a root server. Within that, we can have Indian server, .in, .com, and .mil, whatever the server it might be. Okay, if you have went through .in domain server, or DNS server, again we have one more sub website called as some university.dns.server. Within that, we can have what authoritative domain servers like CSE.btu.in. DTU is a website, website of the university. Similarly, if you want to know about btu.ac.in, within that also we can have PhD programs, MTech programs, and UG programs. Correct? No? Similarly, it follows. Okay. Along with this, it will also provide web caching. It also provides domain conflict can be resolved with the help of domain name system and other details. You can highlight the features of domain name system when they had asked only for 3 marks. What are the services provided by domain name server? Okay, I hope you got the logic of the 3 questions and what you have to answer based on the marks assigned and weightage should be given for what I think I had given in this lecture. In the next lecture, the next question paper solving session will go with the next question paper and next important questions. Thank you so much for your patience listening. Thank you guys. If you have any questions, you can contact me. Thank you.